This year, no one at the Bayanico. It up, you want a dog, I can't. I carry in your way, yes, your feet. No, be not that too many. I want to have a kind of water. Are you already many animals? Guys.
Mudikiriria mwende wa Pacific Waves International Radio ni tabarira yaku wendete tabarira ya Oromwe na Osaba. Tukimemere kiembwa kwembwa kuma guku Seattle, Washington mwena wa America. Na dinoka de wiki tena muthuri we haha. Tondu tugicokereria kumwira atiriri ngimunyita ugeni. Mukurute ma wonie muruna. Umuthi nikirira mama na mwago mama. Kireherwo ni nyekiaru wa prestige mutambo ni rata batakarura mutambo wa Pacific Waves International Radio. Dashoka kwa Facebook ona business wajiraraji na team sanda. Samuari wawaru wakajira alathi kirelia emo na wakent.
Akaere ninyo mwenye.
Samuari duka nyeganyo na mutabo osio.
Tatume nyani zayu.
Mudhuri osio rona sure one joe ne wamu menya.
Na wake ya wakana.
Nokete na kirena mama.
Aria ole ni menyani mare igai. Tenyere la kumara mara.
Kajira gengye chema, nikewe uraruga pere ya drama.
Ila gotara tadoni ne mudhuni, alata nini depa minde. Uro nara menya kwa na mudho idire, sione zitika kia fugi. Ungega sera na mundu gure kuku, isera lini na umikyo.
Kenyan community asari nai.
Uzo nivela wandura gara kako. Minyo ke wandu kajyo mewa. Usiwe nyoro nuke tuwa kia kayo. Kwera kwa musile moduli. Mokoro gaya na wewo niye moruna. Ulyo wakoke nora dime. Ilyana na wewa kera dima jarwa. Luka ikonika na uke.
Northwest Kenyan Community Association, Washington.
Because sharing is caring. Tukareke neighbor aku ahetuko ne mwaga oyo twenagu muthenya wa mothe. Ikana ni jitawo kero wa prestige emwa kwa makuma uko Seattle Washington mwana wa America. Na ne mutabo aku ne to Pacific UFC International Radio. E ni mutabo le rata pataka horora.
You need to tap on your tap at the Kurazi. Kuma, Seattle, Washington, Kenya, Birmingham, Alabama, Arizona, Kenya, Jordan, Saudi Arabia, Kenya, Massachusetts, Kimede, Kenya, Hadegatodo, Nairobi, Kenya, Mombasa, Pacific Waves International Radio, Seattle, Washington. Neidwe number one.
Magi saila sakaji na gaideka modo wagatukuyo. Nedaga ideka. Namada shihadete da. Igre na dage kaidato. Mada ma Pacific. Kure wito Kenya gero. Nedina sana shiaro sine. Namada uramenyivyo. Ne aikari o the afedrowe.
Mada uramenyivyo ni. Pacific Waves Radio. Washington, USA. Minyugi. Nane da Shiruaya.
Ladies and gentlemen, here it is. The most listened to radio show on the planet that the other stations are tuned in to.
Pacific Waves International Radio, Seattle, Washington. Shesheni rirata batakaurura. Meri tuno irata baitaru nishio de dehadu yaruma. America, Africa, Asia, na Europe. Mume bawa Pacific Waves International Radio. Neto igane gabo. Nego tuyoka. We ni we dhafu ito. Neto waku wenyeheri ya tuwa shokia gabo. Neko nyitila kione kigike gitu kenene. Mwe nenyaga aroku rathi manadadi mishiake. Tafarira ishishiode. Tishitu nishiakue mudikiriria na mwenole vivito. Na mwakwe neto waku irira. Koka ashiridia motu kata maito haliwe. Wana kumata matia dugu ito nawe. Pacific Waves International Menyuhi nane na shirumaya. Toto goragia aya gima gatuma dhuda. Tavarila aya orumwe na ushaba. Iruga mire iruane Northwest Kenyan Community Association, Washington.
Nune tavarila ajero. Pacific Waves na management yayo. Try to introduce le todo. Kwa itu gegei aharereidia, zini wa rorele luituru wa gekoyo, na rorele luituru wa Kenya community, toa gekoyo tu, na gai aka tuwa mwole, aka tutengi na gaitiriria maguta, itu ge, stiganete, na tole mare haka haha, magatu ila, tukazikiriria rorele, makara niria na rorele, na makame nyatirire, rorele roreda atea. Haa, dena mudhuri, murata wakwa, edena kutha kire kime nyivyeke haha, joke tukisho kire liyale, Aeke introduction, then we are going to hear from the horse's mouth.
Hinyana urumwa nyoba, uiganaga na mwavigi. Na shetugi enumu, igatuma nyubayo ihade. Ugo nota guyo adumari hamwe megwa taniro. Madhia kahanene onamage kamanene. A Kenya, aliatu ikaraga Washington State, from America. Idwe tugete urumwe nigu hinya witu. Ukahai tunyitane, tureshia na shia nyilu omwe Kenya. Tueda netake kwa na mkogugu. Shia rashia mokone idhano, gaya shubete tiganete. Nogo tirikia na getatuli ya kiri ya kiki. Guatane roitu, neo ugashiru itu. Dumbelelino wale herwane, Pacific Waves International Radio. Menyugi nane da shia rugaya.
Tide ukwe hoya, tokayo ziora. Menyuge, uikare wa mutabo ine, leo tuwapeliria kiriragito, waini wa umode, tuhegio na tutaro ni mudhuri ogwe tuwa, Mr. John Kimani. Ohoro waku.
Nekwega muna.
Yeah.
Nice to be here.
Leo le.
Yeah.
Wena mutikirutete muno guku Washington.
Eh ni tumutangite.
Eh
miaka mingi.
Icio ni gutuhe?
Yes.
Abogethie muthikireria na mwiroreri wa mutambo wa Pacific Waves.
Namugeithia thikireria a Pacific Waves International Radio. It's nice to be here with Mr. Kerry. And he is doing a wonderful job in our community where we need people to communicate and have all the information we have around. So I'm glad to be here, Mr. Kerry, to be with you this this evening.
Yeah.
And it's my pleasure.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. Tutaendelea tukichanganya ruga na pahali naremewa narudi kwa Kikuyu.
Na sawa.
Pahali tutachanganya mpaka Kihibirania.
Yes.
Nataka kusoma jumbe zenyu fupi. Can this cake okofike organize? Is that a organic name or botanic name? Mr. Kerry, I'm to share the link to all audiences. May you kindly translate in English so everyone understands. Thanks so much. Point noted, my brother. I'm going to try. I may not flow well in English, but my host, my guest will communicate in English in all his conversations. Miriam Barega, hello. I can see you live in Pacific. Asante sana. Victoria Destin, nakuona kwa mtambo. Okay, asante sana. Sasa, Mr. Kimani, nataka kukukaribisha. Uweze kusalimia hawa watu. Sasa wasalimie kwa mara ya pili.
Yes.
Then tell us who is Kimani. And who is Northwest Kenyan Community Association?
My name is John Kimani.
Okay.
I'm just one of the community members here in the Northwest. Probably I would say some of the pioneers who came here in a few years back.
Okay.
And back in those days, we used to have a very small community of Kenyans here in the Northwest Seattle area, we used to call it.
Yeah.
It was very, very few of us.
Mm.
And we found that there was a necessity for us to come together and to work together like brothers and sisters.
Yeah.
In those days, we did not discriminate. Anybody from Africa was our brother. We all joined together because we were very few, actually.
Okay.
And we all used to come together, eat together, share together, and support each other. So as the community grew in 2005, that's when we formed the Northwest Kenyan Community Association.
2005?
2005.
Okay.
So it's been quite a few years.
Okay.
You know, and mostly composed of all those people who had come here earlier.
Mm.
And we found it necessary so we can at least be able to access the resources of the state. You know, everything concerning our kids, raising our kids together,
yeah.
And getting our community organized, because we used to live among other communities.
Yeah.
You know, we had the Chinese communities, the Filipino communities, the Korean communities, and we found it necessary for us to come together and work as one group, one people, you know, who would call themselves Kenyans.
Yeah.
And that way we could support one another, and people would have some resources when they come to this country. You know, they would know where to go to find those resources.
Okay.
Yeah.
So Northwest Kenyan community is 14 years old?
Yes.
Okay.
Just about, I would say so, yeah.
What is the mission and vision for Northwest Kenyan community?
The mission was mostly to unite our community.
Okay.
And that was the main mission. Let's unite our community.
Yeah.
And there's we had kids that were being born here.
Okay.
And we found that they lacked their identity. Who were they? Are they Americans? Are they Kenyans?
Yeah.
They could not identify with Kenya because that we had nothing Kenyan.
Yeah.
So we formed the organization to bring those kids and to raise their generation,
yeah.
You know, as Kenyans.
Yeah.
So it was pretty much to unite the Kenyan, you know, as a community.
Yeah.
Yes. And we have done so far, we have done a tremendous job. That's what I would say.
Okay.
Because it's formed by the people that work in the community are all volunteers.
Okay.
People who have tirelessly given their time and resources to build our community to where it is today.
What are the achievements, some of the achievements you can recall for the last 14 years?
Yeah. If you look at the achievements that we can recall, we showed people how to start businesses in this community.
Okay.
And in those days, we did not even have one church.
Okay.
Now we have so many churches in this community.
Okay.
We have, counseled our youth in various ways. We have watched them grow in a community where they can identify themselves as Kenyans. And so if we start to count the achievements that we have achieved and support for our people, you know, we've been there. Believe me, we have worked tirelessly in this community. We have done, you know, so many things. You can't even start to count them. Yes.
There was an instant where Jesus asked his disciples, who do people say I am? As you interact with people, who do people say Northwest is? Maybe you have heard some reports. Maybe dialect or in dialect. Have people, Kenyan community, understood?
Pretty much. For those who just listened to a guard here, for those who have never been in a situation where they needed somebody, they probably would know who Northwest Kenyan community is. But for those who have been in need, you know, they can tell you what Kenyan community and what our community can do when we come together, because they have had the benefits from that community. And not always, people are not always going to see, you know, the work that is being done. Because most of them are not involved. They like to sit on the sides and they'll say, I don't know what they do. And we have called everybody, come and work in the community. Let us grow our community.
Do you have a board in Northwest Kenya community?
We work with a board of 15 board members. And they are all volunteers, professionals from various industries. And they are all volunteers.
Different professionals, eh?
Yes.
In your board, have you included all the tribes that are that lives in Washington that are Kenyan?
Northwest Kenyan community is a non-profit organization, and by that it does not discriminate based on you know, tribes, you know, ethnic or religion. And we have always called for other, you know, tribes to come and work with us. As a matter of fact, yes, we have worked with them. And as much as you can give your time, you get tired and you leave. You know, people have left. So, and we do not discriminate, you know, based on, you know, tribes or anything. And when we work with the Kenyans, when we call Kenyans in this country, you are a Kenyan. We do not look along tribal lines. We are all Kenyans. Under one umbrella.
The reason why I asked you whether in your mission and vision, whether you have achieved the reason why you started Northwest Kenyan community, I wanted to, for us, maybe whether we can look back and see whether there is a gap somewhere that needs to be filled. So I'm going to play one song. Then as we come back, I would like you to identify specifically some of the achievements you have achieved, and some of the achievements maybe you have intended to achieve but somehow you have not achieved. And then I heard somewhere that under the umbrella of Northwest Kenyan community, there is a picnic that has been planned. So we are, you're going to tell us all that. Hamale tojita wakerewa prestige gudhige tukaragia. Na no jari githo gonani. Ndino guthakira rweboro mwe rwa mwanake wi hawe ta gukenyanya na tugicokereria nitukwirwo ni mitaratara iriku. Northwest Kenya community. Makoreto na odoni giuga ha dina miaka iriku madoka America. Dida igwa urwa Northwest. Dida igwa skado, dego hado mathoketie ritwa. No okay, dikio. Tonani hostile dikuga monera wako kana muruga mwakwa no ni gwenda wewe muthikiriria. I would like to engage you with you, my listener. If you have any question to our chairman, Mr. John Kimani, you can post in our I'll read your post. If you have a question, if you have anything, if you have a compliment, you can post in our in my Facebook. As we continue, I'll read those comments, all of them. Remember to share because sharing is caring. Remember, it's Pacific Waves International Radio coming one live from Seattle, Washington, America.
Tavariraya Orumwe na Ushaba. Irugamirirwa ni Northwest Kenyan Community Association, Washington. Hinyana Orumwa Nyoba. Oiganaga na Mothigi. Na shetuge na mu igatumanya ubeyo ihade ugu no taguo adu mari hamwe me gwataniro mathie kanene ona mageka manene a Kenya aria tuikaraga Washington State from America idwe tugite urumwe ni guhinya bitu ukai tunyitane turesia na shianyino mwe Kenya tuedane tagi kwa na mkogugu shiarashia moko ni idhano gayashio bete tiganite no gutiri kiera gitatulia kiria kiki guatanero itu neo ugashiru itu tumbiriri hino ware heruwa ni Pacific Waves International Radio menyugi na neda shiarulaya
naomba kama unaweza kuwa na swali yote kwa mwenyekiti John Kimani wa Northwest Kenyan Community unaweza niandikia hiyo swali na kama utaki kuiweka hapa unaweza enda kwa WhatsApp yangu unaweza pitia chochoro uiweke kwa WhatsApp yangu nambari yangu ni +1 206 966 3152 na hakuna swali sitasoma hakuna comment sitasoma tusikie wimbo moja tu tukirudi tunataka kujua Northwest Kenyan Community wameweza kuachieve their mission and their vision. Na kama kuna mambo hawajaweza, na nitauliza Mr. Kimani, aweza ku-identify by name those few or many achievements wameweza kufanya kama Northwest Kenyan Community. Na kama kunazo hazijafanyika, is there a gap somewhere? Na tunaweza kushirikianaje na mwenyekiti na wengine ambao maybe wanasaidiana na yeye tuweze kujaza hiyo gap. Pia kumbuka kuna picnic imetayarishwa under the umbrella of Northwest Kenyan Community. Kuna kamati imeketi chini inasaidiana na Mr. John Kimani na ndio waliogea na Pacific Waves International Radio Management wakishirikiana na Northwest Kenyan Community. Hiyo kamati kauliza tuwe na siku kadhaa every Monday from 8 to 9 tuwe tunajadiliana mambo ya wa Kenya wote wenye wanaishi katika Washington. Kumbuka ni mtambo wako Pacific Waves International Radio. Steven Getao from Optiven, relax. Katu kwa mtambo. Don't touch that dial.
Yamaha kuigera. Kinyoka iwe kongeru kamoyo. Nimaze na kami tabiko. Mario na gelera mutu lila ime. Relaxi. Kutu saske. Gairi tondara shurika. Relaxi. Kaili tunia shukurika Kaili kewati wa mbode Mwote na wati yonduli wa mulema Niwe mwani waiti yesu le kuandana Nama idona ikibotari kuwana Nope igwa kuri walala Nandewe mwono maki wa shio Madena masio la gerena No amada más huele Cuando yo iré a ti Cuando tú estás que Gai rito te hará chucurica Si la ti Cuando tú estás que Gai rito te hará chucurica
Tafarilaya urumwe na ushaba Urugamiri iruani Northwest Kenyan Community Association, Washington.
Relax, 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 relax,
Dukanyeganyure mutabosho reke tuikirie tunarejea baada ya muda usomruhusu hata kebo kukalia mkiawe hinyana urumwani uba uiganaga na muvigi na shituki numu igatumanyu ubeyo ihade ogwo notaguyo adumari hamwe megwa taniro madhia kahanene onamage kamanene a Kenya aria tuikaraga Washington State from America iduwe tugete urumwe niguo hinya witu ukai tunyitane tureshia na shianyino umwe Kenya tuedane tage kwa na mkogugu shiarashia mokone idhano gayashi ubete tiganete nogo tirikia ragita tuuri ya kiria kiki guatanero itu neo ugashiru itu Dumbiririno wa reherwo ni Pacific Waves International Radio. Menyugi na neda shiarugaya. Kuma Seattle, Washington, Kenya, Birmingham, Alabama, Arizona, Kenya, Jordan, Saudi Arabia, Kenya, Massachusetts, Kimede, Kenya, Hadege, Gatodo, Nairobi, Kenya, Mombasa. Pacific Waves International Radio, Seattle, Washington. Neidwe number
1. Okay. Mr. Kimani chairman. Najua kunazo goals mlikuwa nazo. Wakati mlianza Northwest Kenyan Community. For the last 14 years, have you achieved all those goals?
Not yet.
Not yet.
And I don't think we're going to achieve them anytime soon. Because it's an ongoing work.
Okay.
Yeah, the work of a community, building a community and good, bringing all our people together to work as one people is an ongoing work. They're going to be going even for many years after we are gone.
Okay.
Even if you look at the most successful communities, there is still a lot of work to be done. So we have not achieved all the goals that we had intended to achieve because our goal was to unite our community as one community of Kenyans.
Okay.
Yes.
What are some of the challenges you have encountered, Northwest Kenyan Community Association have encountered for the last 14 years?
We have encountered a lot of challenges, and one of them that is very close to my heart is our youth.
Okay.
You know, the way we raise our youth in this country, you know, it's a challenge to every parent because I've been a parent myself.
Okay.
So communication with our youth, you know, the parents and the youth, that's one of the main challenges we face in this community.
Okay.
Because if you can grow a community, you cannot grow a community where you are not working together with your youth.
Okay.
They have to emulate what the elders are doing, what the parents are doing, what the pastors are doing. And this has been our main challenge. And it's understandable because some of these youth come here when they are about 7 years, 7 years, 9 years. So they are transferred from one culture to a different one where it takes them time to adjust. And the first thing they want to do is to try and fit in, not to fit in the Kenyan community, but to fit in the American community.
So they are American Kenyans?
American Kenyans.
Okay.
Sometimes some of them don't even quite know where they stand.
Yeah.
Because the ones that are born here cannot actually call themselves Kenyans. The ones that are born in Kenya are Kenyans and Americans. So they have those challenges. And when you try to reach out to them, it becomes very challenging even for you because they are running away from the culture that they left back in Africa, in Kenya. And they are adapting a new culture.
Okay.
So when you try to bring them back to who they truly are,
yeah,
you know, it becomes, you know, like a tug of war.
Yeah.
It becomes like a tug of war.
Yeah.
So that has been our main challenge, and we have lost a lot of them, you know, through the same things that any other youth in any community goes through.
Yeah.
We have lost a lot of them because there was no structure for them to come and fit in. The people who are charged with creating and building their structure is us, as the community elders, the community members.
Okay.
We build a structure for them.
Mm.
You know, that I have always said in the years past that is we are building a foundation for them and create a platform where they can come and work on their platform.
Yeah.
So there are so many challenges in our community, and the challenges of even us who are the community members not being quite united, not giving of ourselves to come and work in our community and grow their community.
Let me take you back a little bit. Eh? Mm. You have a board.
Yes, we do.
The Northwest Kenyan Community Association have a board. Mm-hmm. Have you included a number of youths in your board?
We have had youths. We have had, as you know, our former secretary, Mr. Getao.
Okay.
He was a youth when he joined the Northwest Kenyan community. We had Nyarubwa. Okay. We have had others. We even had a subcommittee of youth. It was called Kaya.
Mm.
It was read by Jogona Gishoro, my daughter, Angela, you know, and some other kids.
Okay.
It used to be a youth unit. In the Northwest Kenyan community.
Mm.
But as you know, when they grow up, they go to college, they move to other states, they have other interests, they no longer want to serve their community.
Mm.
So we have always called them to come and work with us so can they can reach the youth.
Mm.
Because their communication between us and our youth is so important, it's paramount.
Okay.
And if we lose that, then we lose their generation.
Okay, at the end of the show, now, we are almost to end the show in the next 15 minutes.
Okay.
I would like to ask you, and I don't want you to answer now, what would you like Northwest Kenyan Community Association be remembered when you are not there or when you are there? Many years to come, what would you like Northwest Kenyan Association to be remembered of? But now, I want to ask you about the culture.
Yes.
You have said that one of the challenges you have heard is you raise a generation, they don't know whether they are Kenyans or they are Americans.
Exactly.
It's a hybrid.
Yes.
It's a hybrid.
Yes.
What are the efforts you as Northwest Kenyan Community Association is doing to collect these?
Yes. The only way we can work this out is to work with the parents.
Okay.
And we have found out that some of them come here and they become so busy working and making a living, which is expected of them.
Yeah.
Those are the people that can come in the community and work with the community, and by that we'll be able to reach, you know, their youth, to reach their kids.
Yeah.
There are so many programs that we could have facilitated that would have helped a lot.
Mm.
You know, and there is have a central place where we can bring these kids all the time.
Mm.
But for that to happen, we have to work with the parents.
Okay.
But the parents show very little interest at times, you know, but and because some of them are very busy working and making a living. Yeah.
Okay. Have you extended your hand to other stakeholders, maybe to help you in this challenge?
We have. We have always called for...
maybe confusing these parents, talk to these parents.
Yes.
Yeah.
We have always talked to the parents.
Yeah.
We have had conferences with our youth.
Mm.
You know, some of them, we have had youth that committed suicide in our community. And after that, our youth would be so charged up, they would ask us to hold a conference for them. And then we would start those conferences. We will get them speakers, counselors, who would come and talk to them. And eventually, they will fizzle off. You know, it would die off. The momentum would die because the parents do not have the follow through. We as the Northwest Kenyan Community Board can facilitate things, but we also have the partnership with the parents. We need to partner.
Okay, the Bible says, bring up a child in the way he should go.
Yes.
And when he grows up, he will not depart to those ways.
Yes.
A child will do what he see.
Exactly.
The parent doing.
Mm-hmm.
Now you're saying the parents are very busy, maybe trying to earn a living, to make ends meet.
Yes.
This is a challenge.
Mm-hmm. Yes, yes.
Okay.
And it's universal. It's not just in our community.
Yeah.
Even in Kenya, it is a challenge.
Yeah.
Even to get those youth to go to church with you on Sunday or Saturday, which is the Sabbath.
Yeah.
It is also a challenge.
Yeah.
Yeah. So you have to really, really work it.
You see, my mother, I was brought up in Catholic. My mother would do something.
Yes.
Very early in the morning on Sunday, he would give us an offering. He'll tell us, prepare yourself for church.
Yes.
He will escort us to the church door. Then she will go back and she will come later.
Yes.
So she taught us that every Sunday we need to go to the house of the Lord.
Yes. Yes.
So now we come here. Maybe like going to church, it has been taken as AOP, any other business.
Yes.
It's not a priority.
Mm-hmm.
There's a committee that sat down and under the umbrella of Northwest Community Association, and they told me, you're organizing a picnic. Mm-hmm. So I say, let's have a short break. Okay. As we come back, you're going to tell us more about that picnic. Let me read a few text messages. Stephen Bogwa Mute, manager from Optiven, is, I can see you. Great show, see you, thanks. Forbes, bots, salams kwenyu, tumezipokea. Haya, Queen Kamau, joined, asanti, Queen Kamau. Grace Mau tuned in a peace, in peace, Pierce County. That's how you pronounce it, Pierce County, Pura Beria.
Yes.
Grace Mau, thanks so much. Na kuona kwa mtabu. Peter Wajiro, the efforts to work out together with parents, yeah. Her Peter Wajiro, Northwest Kenyan Community Association is in America, bringing the community together. I meant to, okay, yeah. This our listener from Saudi Arabia.
Oh.
Saudi Arabia.
Welcome.
Yeah. Yes. Queen Kamau from Fedrobe, CEO Kerry Prestige High, with your guest, Jokirele Kiotaraj. Nilikuona kitambo. Jerry Wasien from Fedrobe, nakuona. Zipora Wainimo Pastor, we are hearing you well and clear. Thank you, Chairman. You know this pastor?
Oh, yes.
Yeah, Pastor Zipora
with the committee that is working on our picnic.
Yeah.
She's working very hard.
And they are doing a good job.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
One of our pastors in the community.
Yeah.
Yes.
Tavariraya Orumwena Oshaba. Iruga Meriruni, Northwest Kenyan Community Association, Washington. Hinyana Orumwa Nyoba. Oiganaga Namodhigi. Nashituki Namu. Igatumanyu Beyo Ihade. Ogwenotaguyo Adumari Hamwe Meguataniro. Madhiyak Hanene Onamage Kamanene. A Kenya. Ariatu Ikaraga Washington State. From America, iduwe tugete urumwe niguwe hinya witu. Ukai tunyitane, tureshia na shia njino yamwe Kenya. Tuedane tage kwa na mkogugu. Shia rashia mokone idhano, gayashio bete tiganete. Nogo tirekia rageta tori ya kiri ya kiki. Guataniro itu, neo ogashiru itu. Tomberili yuna ware herone, Pacific Waves International Radio. Menyugi na neda shiaru gaya.
Uyo na jomba ukepo ya kerida, kito mimoge ne motare. Ninge kae wa koruka anoite, utakwa niati ya kogeni. Yes, you need a van at the Bayanico. Ita, you want a doctor, a kia. A kaere, then you bring it as your rocky. No, they not that to many other you. Now, I can't tell you what I
am. But in Aya, old Mino Shaba. Northwest Kenyan Community Association.
Aria Revi Menyani Marigai, Tenyere La Kumara Mara. Umu Benegua Udonde Kagarusio, Mokoro Ulea Bonigi. Kiambere Vya Kemenyo Etiye Rangai, Tukana Tiembere Isembe. Maoya Menyani Jose Moeteregi, Otire Vya Jaga Yoti.
Kumasiaro, Washington, Kenya, Birmingham, Alabama, Arizona, Kenya, Jordan, Saudi Arabia, Kenya, Massachusetts, Kemede, Kenya, Hadegatodo, Nairobi, Kenya, Mombasa, Pacific Waves International Radio, Seattle, Washington, Naidwe, number one.
Pacific Waves International Radio, the leading radio in America. Na tumefurahi kumwalika chairman wetu, John Kimani. Now, Mr. John Kimani, you have done a noble job and effort to reach some men in the community, the committee that is organizing the picnic on 17th, Pastor Spora, Wainimu included. I know there will be a lot of activities, and there will be a football match, a soccer for our youths. What are we expecting on that day?
Let me say we are very happy with the group, the subcommittee that is organizing the picnic led by Mr. Bogwa, Edward, Pastor Zipora, Pastor Mwara, our treasurer from the board, Mr. Kirori, and also Pastor Mwara is in our board. Those are people who have given their time to organize this picnic. The purpose of this picnic, we are trying to bring all our people together. And we are not looking at just the Northwest. We want our whole entire community of the Kenyan community to come. And let us sit down together. Let us share bread together. Let us communicate. Let us talk and probably start a new page in our lives here in the Northwest. Because we have a lot to do. And one of the main issues we want to deal with is to reach our youth. That's the one, some of the group is involved in the soccer team. We are trying to reach them and to embrace them and to call them to come and work with us in the community. We have a lot of things that we can share with them freely. They don't have to, you know, pave the way or find their way. We have already, you know, paved the way for them. All they have to do is learn from us. And they are our kids, and we have called them. We want to embrace them. We want to bring them closer, you know, so they can reap the benefits, you know, that, you know, we have been able to achieve in this community. So it is a picnic that is trying to bring everybody together to show that we are one people and we are Kenyan and we can work together. The Kenyan community itself has a lot of economic power. Also political power in this country. We can decide who's going to be a House representative in the state of Washington by the sheer numbers of our votes. And until we put all of those together and the economic power that we have, we are not reaching the resources that we are entitled to. God has blessed this community. We have people that have achieved a lot in our community. We have professionals. We have people that work for Microsoft. We have people, the engineers that work for Boeing. We want to bring all these people, you know, from the oldest to the youngest, and let us come together as one community and grow this community that we love so dearly.
Okay. Mr. Kimani, I would like to know the pillars the foundation of Northwest Kenyan community. But I will say this, because I know you are a man of God. The Bible says that to whom much is given, much is expected.
True.
I don't know whether it's a challenge I'm going to throw to you on camera. Of late, we have had a lot of fitukos and some deaths by our youth. Mm-hmm. And now, this Kenyan community is your baby. Mm-hmm. Because now, you see, mention Kimani Watakoma, Kimani chairman. Yeah, yes. You see, and now there's now these wazes who have come on board to assist you guys under the umbrella of Northwest Kenyan Community Association. As much is given to you, much is expected.
Yes.
What are you going to tell the Kenyan community people who are listening? Because there are many. Yes. Stella Monge, I can see you. Well, this is great. Even this Honorable Mary Jambi, you remember, is a nominated MCA in Mike Sonko's government.
Yes.
You remember when Piri Piri was thrown?
Yes.
He was the one who was saying, she's the one.
Oh, yes.
So even readers,
yes,
even political readers, recent our channel.
Yes.
You guys, you are. I don't want to say you are you'll be accountable, but people are asking why are all how comes all this is happening? And we have Northern Kenyan Community Association. What have you done to prevent all this?
One thing I would have to say, and I give all the glory and honor to God, you know, for my life and for the position and the work that he has given for all those years. Had it not been for him, I wouldn't be doing this. Let me just say, our community have challenges, just like any other community. The community is growing. So many kids are being born. And the only time we are touched is when we lose a loved one. And that is natural. And it's going to continue happening. It is only that at times we lose more than, you know, we thought to be, I don't even want to call it, you know, to be expected. And especially when these are our youth. We lost a lot of youth this year. But let me say this. There is, God has blessed us in this community. And we just joined with the pastor's fellowship led by Reverend Wanyoike. We had a meeting with them, the Northwest Kenyan community and the fellowship of the pastors. And we had a very wonderful day, you know, of prayer where we prayed for the community. We brought all the community members and all the pastors, most of the pastors, let me say that, to a day of prayer to talk to the Lord, you know, because the Bible says, if my people will humble themselves, you know, so that's what we were trying to do. Turn to the Lord. Because as much as we are blessed, it's so easy in this country to walk away, you know, from our roots, you know, of believing in God. And then we start looking at the material things that we have achieved after we come to this country. So there are challenges, and the challenges are going to remain. But we are asking every community member to come and join with us. There are so many small organizations in our community these days. But you have to remember, Northwest Kenyan community is the umbrella for all those other organizations. We just had a picnic with our Kenya One North, where we went with their chairman last Saturday. And there was a day to behold. So we work with all these communities. We are one community after all. And we are calling all of them to come and work with the umbrella, you know, so we can achieve what we are supposed to achieve.
We have a friend here, Wehoke Mwadhani.
You know him.
Oh, you know him, eh?
He's
your neighbor.
He's my neighbor.
Frank, this guy we launched his CD the other day. Frank Wanikore Guy, our able chairman in Washington State. Frank Wanikore Guy.
And we are inviting him to bring all the musicians to our picnic.
On 17th.
On the 17th,
I'm the CEO. Well, you see, because I'm used in my vernacular, now all my shows are vernacular. He said that you need to give me a drink after this. Maybe a cold soda. Non-alcoholic. Any drink that is non-alcoholic.
I think you're doing very well.
Even if it's some water. Okay, Frank, we thank God for you. Thanks so much. Jen Carisomo, I want to appreciate some of the groups that will be supporting you, that will be together with you on 17th. The Seattle Moja FC.
Yes.
It's a soccer team in Seattle. They'll be there. They'll be doing the soccer, the Pastor's Fellowship in Washington. I don't know whether it's in Seattle.
I see.
They'll be there. And many other groups. Even Pacific Waves International Radio.
Even the youngest group of the Utu. They call themselves Utu. And we love that group because they have been doing some wonderful you know, things in our community.
Frank, Mr. Kimani, nikitaka kama kuna jambo unasikia ukitaka kusema, tutaka kupea hii nafasi, even as you conclude, na maybe you can touch something about the hiyo kamati na inatayarisha that meet the picnic.
Let me just say the committee that is doing the picnic, led by Mr. Edward Bogwa, Pastor Zipora, Pastor Mwara, and Mr. Kirori, they are doing a tremendous job. They are trying to reach out to our community, and they are inviting all the community businesses to chip in, you know, to offset the expenses of this picnic. This is a day that we are planning to have a huge day. And we are asking all our small businesses, whatever you can give towards this picnic. Mm. And even our churches, mm. we are asking the churches, because after all, most of the members mm. of our Northwest Kenyan community belong to these churches.
Yeah.
We are asking the churches to support the picnic with only $200.
Okay,
from
okay.
every church. If we can reach every church
yeah.
to give $200, we have our picnic done.
Okay.
And then we'll be up there to behold.
And other stakeholders.
Yeah. And what we are trying is to see if we can pull all the youth to come.
Mm.
You know, bring all the youth, let us meet with them, let us communicate with them,
mm.
and let them see that we can get together and have a wonderful time.
Are we going to have t-shirts and banner for Northwest there?
Yeah, we will have some t-shirts, yes. Mm. And the banners, the committee that is organizing is taking care of all of
them. Yeah, because yes. in case Pacific West mm. thinks of coming
yes.
with free t-shirts,
mm-hmm.
you will carry the credit of the day, because
yes.
everybody will see Pacific International t-shirts.
Yes, yes, yes. But that would be a good idea. We would like to see everybody dressed in the same t-shirt
yeah.
from the Northwest. But believe me,
yeah.
our presence is more important than the t-shirt.
Yeah.
Just to be there, just yeah. to see the young man or young lady there
okay.
interacting, you know, with the generation that have been here for a while.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I'd like to say, to add that the board of the Northwest Kenyan community, I really commend what they have done over the years.
Okay,
most
okay.
of them have been there for many years.
Okay.
When you see an individual dedicated there, life,
mm.
you know, to
for
better, yeah, to better the life of others,
mm.
that is a gift that you cannot even imagine.
Okay,
you know, it can only come from God.
Okay,
because those people are dedicated, to our community. They have given their time and mm. they are committed.
Yeah,
they are committed. That's the Northwest Kenyan Community Board.
Okay,
yes.
Shout of praise, ministers will be there. Your last word?
My last word is, if we would come together, we would have a community, a formidable community that can do anything.
Okay.
We have seen what we can do because with the support that we give each other in our community. As a matter of fact, you cannot find another community that do things the way we do.
Yeah.
Because we have compassion for each other.
Mm.
We take care of each other. We care for each other. And mm. this is what, you know, the Bible is calling us to do.
Mm.
And we take care of the poor. We take care of the sick, mm. you know. We take care of those who are in distress.
Mm.
If we can come together and harness all our powers together, God-given powers together,
mm.
whether it's financial, whether it's political,
mm.
we can make a difference. The difference that we're going to make, we are not the ones that are going to benefit from this difference.
Mm.
It is our generation that is coming after us.
Mm.
And their generation, we'll find out there are people who committed their time and money to build a platform for them.
Okay.
We are the only people here mm. that works the same, that work, do things the way we do.
Mm.
And you know what we do here in our community.
Okay.
We decided a long time ago that we will never leave any one of us behind.
Okay.
And we have walked together through this journey so far.
Mm.
And we are not going to start now.
Okay.
Yes.
We are so grateful, Mr. Kimani.
Thank you.
Chairman.
Yes.
Next Monday, we'll have the same show.
Mm-hmm.
We hope to see maybe
yes.
another, you said somebody else.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe from your board
yes.
or from the committee that is organizing the picnic.
Yes.
And we'll be glad to air Amen. This show
yes.
for 1 hour
mm-hmm.
coming Monday.
Yes.
Yeah.
We appreciate what you are doing
yeah.
in our community,
yeah.
one of the small businesses. And I know you are already supporting the picnic.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yes.
And yeah. I'm one of the sponsors.
Yes.
Yeah,
I'm
yeah.
calling everybody to come. Let us unite as Kenyans
mm.
and we can do marvelous things.
Amen.
Yes.
Muthirikiria mwendwa ni mutambo wakwa Pacific West International Radio ukureheirwo ni kiario wa prestige na tafadhali na umuthi ikurugamirirwo ni Northwest Kenyan Community Association. Bye bye, tusamani rosiro sine 5:30 nginya 6:30 tafadhali kuendelea ya muruna wakwa uraidia tena watidate hada toka tukorani kiria kia Biblia na next Monday tukwa kuna tafadhali teo and we are trying to reach our youth kuria mali. Our youth are our babies. Mr. Chairman, did I talk about America? Told the daddy, Mohiniri, Ku, Hanini,
yes.
Hemo do Ajira, Tri, Onoko Kiyaga, Domito, we call it America.
Yes.
Makiyaga.
Yes.
Oroko, yeah. Even if you are going to do door to door,
yes,
yes, door to door, trying to reach our youth,
yeah, that is our future.
We have to do that,
yes,
yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. So Zibaro Elimo, thank you, Chairman. Tuko pamoja. Na okay, next time next Monday we might organize to to call on air some of these committee members.
Yes.
Maybe we hear
you them. More than welcome to invite them here.
I don't want to surprise Zipora. Yes. Or let's call Zipora.
Yes.
Zipora, let's call you and say a word on air. People would like to see you. Yeah. Hello.
Hello.
Mchungaji, habari yako?
Salama kabisa, habari yako?
Mzuri sana. Tulikuwa na tulipoanzia show yetu na Mr. John Kimani.
Yes.
Do you have to say something?
I want to say thank you very much to Chairman, even for availing himself. I think we have never had a beautiful show like today.
Okay.
To see him there on air, we are so happy and very excited to hear the plans the Northwest has for us.
Yeah.
And even you, Brother Kerry, we want to appreciate you for giving our chairman that opportunity. It is wonderful.
Yeah.
Yes.
Do you have a word to our Kenyan community, Kenyans who are living in Washington?
Yes, I think I want to say the time has come for us to put the past behind us and start a new page. And especially we want to tell our young people we love them and we want them to come on board. We are ready to give them this baton so that they can carry it on to their next generation. And we are very excited with the leadership of the chairman because we've had him on air saying that he wants the youth to come so that we can continue working together. I think that's the best thing that can happen to us at this time.
Pastor Zipora, you have been a soldier.
Yes.
You have been in the front line as a soldier reaching our youth.
Yes.
Where is this passion coming from? All this passion?
This person comes from this. I cannot be good enough to go there. That is the one Bishop Wako.
Bishop Mude. Bishop Mude.
Bishop Thomas Mude. I will go there. I do. 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 I do.
I do.
So that is where the passion comes from. Besides also that me, I am a teacher. I have been working with young people. I have seen how they can prosper if they are guided in the right way. So with all that passion, I think it is important for us to pass this baton to the next generation.
Okay.
Yes.
And we are so grateful to your committee that is dancing with Northwest Kenyan community tonight for us a picnic. What do we expect from that picnic on 17th?
Brother Kerry, I think I don't want to say let people come because they are very good things. We don't want to to tell them right now, but in the time we will. But I want to tell them to come. There are very many good and fun-filled activities. And more to that, we are very excited because we have our Seattle Umoja football team that will be playing that day. Many people don't even know that it exists. Yes, they've been winning leagues. Last week they had a league, they won 8-0. We want to, that's one of the activities.
Is that fair, beating a team 8-0?
we will ask the captain and the coach whether that is fair, but I believe it because they are very good. Actually, they were playing with one of the teams from Europe.
Okay, Zipola, Pastor Zipola.
Yes.
Thanks so much for receiving our calls. God bless you.
Amen.
Yeah.
Thank you and God bless you and me, our chairman. We are supporting you and we want you to succeed. It is our prayer. We know you have done a tremendous job for our community. God bless you and keep you long.
Thank you
very much, Pastor. Nice to hear from you.
Anna Ilongo is saying, Chairman, we want to see you here more often. You are the face of Northwest. Thanks, Blombash. Thanks so much. Bye-bye. See you tomorrow. God bless you. God bless you. I'm